That was a zigzag run-up, if ever there was one. He was in behind the umpire, then darting out, then taking pace off the ball. Difficult to time the ball initially on the surface.
It's a good point you make, and I see a distinct change in the Trident's approach. They're just making sure they're getting set and building a base before they really go hard in the back 10 overs. There's no run there. And I think they, like a number of teams, but I think particularly they are a standout side that have... You can nearly put it down as being a little bit reckless and gung-ho with their approach and being a little bit sort of focused more on boundary hitting against building an innings and building a strong base and taking advantage of their power hitters in the second half of the 10 overs.
Well, they're trying everything. Over the wicket, round the wicket, back over the wicket, back around. 43 for 18 gone. Far on it.
Oh, it's lovely that.
Mixing up the googlies and the leg breaks. And I wonder what Mears himself has learnt from that innings he played last time. It was a brilliant innings, but as you mentioned, problems with the googly.
Oh, lovely boy, lovely.
He was against Sandeep Lamashana and it appears that he was bowling a little bit quicker than what Farwood Ahmed is bowling here. Farwood is really inviting the batsman to run at him and have a go, where Sandeep was a lot quicker through the air and therefore the decision was a lot more rushed.
Gets that away for four. Charles does play that sweep shot quite effectively.
Farwood Ahmed just getting a little leg side and Johnson Charles managing to get that well behind square. There is a fielder station square on the boundary, but he is very square. He just has to beat that 45 who's sitting on the ring.
Goes for the sweep again, has got enough on it, it's a hero maximum. Wow, he's prospering with that sweep and Farwood can't believe it.
And that hero maximum brings up Johnson Charles' 2000th run in CPL and it's also brought up his team 50. So two milestones.
Only two other players have 2,000 and more. Chris Gayle and Lendl Simmons in Hero CPL, 54 for one. For Charles, Pollard round the wicket. Double arm swing, and that's an ugly hoik from Mares.
He's a bit of a silent achiever, Johnson Charles, and he's made his way up that chart. A lot of people may be surprised to see him in third position, but he's been a consistent performer. The other thing to note is that the top three are all opening batsmen, so they're the ones that are facing the most amount of balls, or getting the opportunity to face the most amount of balls. Heaved away to the leg side. Not the timing there, but they'll pick up a couple. I should correct myself, it was top four, because there's Andre Fletcher sitting there in fourth position, just a little bit behind. Some very good innings from Johnson Charles. Always favours that leg side, whether it be off the front foot or the back foot. Also strong with a cut shot. But primarily, he'll score at least 70% of his runs through that leg side with that strong bottom hand. That's exactly where Kyle Mares is looking as well, that leg side. We saw him play some huge pickup sweep slogs over the leg side during that wonderful 85 the other day.
What I also thought Mares did the other night in that 85 was he played ball over extra cover and over point as well with two glorious shots. So he'll be hoping to give Charles as much support, but also as much striking power now as we approach the halfway mark of the innings. Challenge at this surface, really. You can bowl a lot of cross seamers, you can bowl cutters on here as a seamer. There's a leg cutter from Kieran Pollard, almost the undoing of Charles. Very well fielded. That's to Akil Hussain's strong hand, his favourite hand. He's left-handed, and that was an excellent stop. Commiserations to Akil. He lost his dad earlier this year in March, and that hit him really hard. Good young kid. Wish him all the best. Wouldn't be easy having to have that misfortune and organize a funeral during the pandemic where you're limited. That was tough. Sedate for the first 10 overs of this batting effort. Conditions demand it. Time for the Angostura LLB drinks break.
Barbados Tridents are 1 for 59 after 10. The drinks break happening. And of course, Barbados, what a gem. What an absolute gorgeous part of the world. Yeah, get in there, brother. And kite surfing. Oh, you can do it all. Carlisle Bay. Oh, yes. Get into the surf and on the gas and having a great time, because we love it here. Diving with the turtles and the underwater world. Oh, simply sensational. That's Nick Miller's house. What a great spot. Very spoilt in this part of the world. Cozy as hanging out in Barbados. Right, our back line. It's Teon Webster. Usual action, Samuel B. How are you?
Hello, Danny. And hello to all those who are tuned in. This match promises much. The defending champions, Barbados Tridents, up against three-time champions, Trinbago Knight Riders. Last year, the Tridents dominated the Knight Riders. Earlier this season, Knight Riders defeated the Trident, so it's been a seesaw battle the last year or two. But these two in particular, Johnson Charles got a half century against the Knight Riders in the earlier match. Kyle Mears, brilliant 85 in the last. So there's some confidence out in the middle. And the approach thus far to this particular innings has been quite good. Quite different certainly from what we've seen so far. So they've done the hard work, they're doing the hard work, they just want to continue and to ensure that they get to that total perhaps of 140. If they can push the 150, they can really challenge this Trinbago Knight Riders batting lineup.
Also just been enlightened, this is the first time that Teon Webster has actually bowled in the Hero CPL. So once again from Kyron Pollard, a bit of strategy of pace off the ball. Pollard himself over and round and lots of little cutters. Very similar here to Webster. It's still not coming on, is it? Subtle little cutters and changes of pace. And even though Johnson Charles was now 46 and has been there from the onset, still not quite timing it as well as he'd like. A lot of hard work on this 22 yards.
And Pollard, with all of his experience, the most capped T20 player in the history of the game, this one is pulled away into the gap. So length presented there from Teon Webster, and thank you very much, Kyle Mears.
And all that experience has got to come to the fore. Mentioned patience with Darren Ganga earlier. Batters have got to give themselves a chance. Hang in. Play catcher. Plenty of different little action there from Webster. Finishes the 11th. The Tridents are 68 for one now. Watch this, here we go, a little, oh, he holds on to it. There's a little subtle delay there in his action. Interesting. You think about Ashwin, don't you? That little pause. Interesting.
Sixty-eight for one after 11. El Dorado Skycam. Wonderful images that we've been seeing throughout this tournament, both venues, the Brian Lara Cricket Academy, as well as here in the capital city at the Queen's Park Oval. I was about to mention, Danny, the experience of Kyron Pollard once again, understanding the requirements of the game. He has in his ranks two left-hand orthodox bowlers who still have overs in Kari Pierre, as well as Akhil Hussain, who has one left. But because Kyle Mayers is at the crease, he's a little bit reluctant and hesitant to bowl these bowlers, and so he's gone for the part-timer in Tion Webster. And he feels certainly that it is a much more difficult bowler to score off as opposed to the left-hand orthodox coming into the left-handed Kyle Mayers.
So strong there. This will be the challenge for young Seals, particularly against Johnson Charles, who loves the ball sliding on. So Seals in his development, again, that whole thing of having a repertoire at this level.
And we have seen too how quickly a game can change. One over, a very expensive 20-25 runs, and it changes the entire complexion of the match. And Karen Pollard is very cognizant of that and is trying to avoid that from happening.
Sounded good. Oh, and it is. Picked out a little pocket there, one of his go-to areas for Kyle Mayers. Partnership is 50 now between these two.
Yeah, friendly full toss on offer here from Jaden Seals. Just missing his length, really. And Kyle Mayers, full of confidence and full of power, completes a hero maximum. Just a nice little phase here for the Barbados Tridents.
Now he gives it a thump. Really does give it a thump, as Kyle Mayers. So, rotating strike, both getting a fair share of it. Johnson Charles. Excited. Well, here's the hero maximum race. And oh, Mayers and Lewis. Jason Holder not far behind with Glenn Phillips and Darren Bravo. But Mayers and my mate Lewis. Evan Lewis with those fast hands. So two lefties at the top of the tree with the maximum race. Oh, you're kidding me! Eyeing up a 50, there's a full toss, and it's time for Charles to depart.
An innocuous looking delivery here again from Jaden Seals, a full toss. And Johnson Charles just trying to place it more than power it. But instead he finds the fielder Lyndall Simmons at backward point. And straight at him. An El Dorado celebration for Jaden Seals. We don't mind how they come as a bowler. The second one falls for the Barbados Tridents. Charles for a well-played 47. 77 for two.
Tall figure of the skipper, Jason Holder, and it is a usual posse these days at number four. One to go in the 12th. Seals produces a lovely full one that the captain negotiates. 12 done. It's 77 for two now. Both openers are out. And Simmons has got both catches. Alrighty, let's go sideline to Big Ian Bishop.
Yeah, great to be down here beside such great machinery as well as Cowie Pier continues. And that goes over third man as well, so got a special guest with me, Nikhil Utamchandani, who is with the Barbados Tridents staff. Nikhil, tell us a little bit about what your role is with the Tridents.
Yeah, hello, Bish. Great to be here. Hi to all the TV crew. I am really a content creator for the Barbados Tridents. I deal with their social medias, as well as I am, in normal circumstances, the public relations officer. But obviously, with the COVID pandemic, we haven't been able to travel as much, but I'm really enjoying the role, and I'm grateful to the Trident staff for backing me and giving me the opportunity.
And that, in the meantime, has gone away for four, so there's a shift in gear. And you're also a budding commentator here.
Yes, Bish. It's been my dream from 11 years old to do cricket commentary, so me being here working for the Tridents and even speaking to guys that you all are, you know, progressing my future in terms of being a cricket commentator, hopefully in a couple of years' time.
Where did this passion come from, broadcasting?
It came from my hometown club, Wanderers Cricket Club. I would have done some commentary there. A guy by the name of Gary Bell would have allowed me to, you know, put things in place to be able to display my voice and give my analysis. And I was able to do some cricket commentary just as a young boy, so some youth cricket, and from there it just grown to leaps and bounds into cricket commentary.
So who are the other West Indian players at your club? Give us some of the famous names at your club.
Well, we've had Kerr Edwards, former West Indies captain, of course. Jason Holder currently is at Wanderers. We have Raymond Rifa, Shane Mosley, who's in the West Indies test setup. So yeah, we've got some great players. I think we're the best club in the Caribbean, actually, Bish. So yeah, I think the name speaks for itself.
I need to put you out of the Queen's Park Oval for having said that. It's a lovely shot. Drop though by Tion Webster. It's an excellent effort. And Jason Holder at your club as well?
Yes, Jason Holder is there. I'm close to Jason, and great to have spent some time with him here for the Tridents. But yeah, whenever he has a chance, he comes back, plays some games for us, and we're always have open arms for him to come back. Go on.
We'll come back to you, Nikhil, after this over is completed. 84 for 2. I suppose the Tridents would dearly love to win. Nikhil, great to have you here with us once again. I'm going to ask you to do a little commentary here, and I hope that your role model is not Danny Morrison. Don't tell me that Danny Morrison is your role model, please.
No, I've actually spoken to Danny last year's tournament. He's taught me a lot, so I think Danny's one of the most established guys, you know, in terms of you guys, so I really learned a lot from him.
Sad to hear that. All yours, Nikhil.
Yeah, I think Fawad Ahmed here, he's caused some problems in this tournament so far. That's a cracking shot from Kyle Mears into the gap through mid-wicket. A boundary for Kyle. He's been in really good touch. We saw that 85 in the last game, Bish, and I think, you know, he's taken the charge to Fawad Ahmed. It's what's needed to be done.
He did have some problems, but he had a good first class season, didn't he?
Yeah, he had an extremely good first class season, and he was just telling you, when you're able to score that many runs in the first class setup as well as 50 and now come to do well in the T20 tournament, I think it shows how good of a player you really are. And that's well played by Kyle. Bish, what I think Kyle Mears has done really well throughout this tournament that I've observed, his ability to get in, for his first say 15 to 20 deliveries, and then is also able to then kick on as we saw in the last game. And I think on this surface where we saw cause a lot of problems for a batsman, I think Kyle has done the perfect thing for the Tridents here to get a big score.
and they haven't been easy pitches to adapt on, particularly coming out of Barbados, where I suppose historically the pitches tend to be a little bit more true.
Yeah, and I think it's going to be key for Jason, as you mentioned about the pitches. He's someone that's really, I'm really impressed with him in terms of backing himself. I've told him this, coming up the order and batting at five, I think it's really added a lot to our side.
Oh, fast. Lovely fast.
And yeah, I wish you could tell me what you think about the surfaces. I know yesterday watching those games, it had a lot more grass on it, but today it seems to, the ball seems to be coming on a bit more now with, I think they've shaved the grass.
I love how this interview has switched around. I'm now being interviewed by the rookie. Yeah, I was surprised, first of all, that the pitches were so dry and so spin-friendly at the start of this period of Hero CPL, but I can understand the pandemic would have had a lot of effects, Nikhil, to the Queen's Park Cricket Club here. So, look, we really appreciate you taking some time to come here to be with us, and we're going to try and wish you all the best in your broadcasting career. Hopefully this won't be the last time you're here at the Hero CPL. So, single off that last ball. Nikhil, keeper, remember that name. 92 for 2.
Yeah, lovely stuff, Ian Bishop. Nikhil is sideline. A friendly face around the Hero CPL in his last few years, the youngster. Very keen in terms of broadcast and all things with it. Bright future. Ticking along, lost Johnson Charles in a way just at the wrong juncture, because he was, apart from eyeing up the milestone at 50, been in from the outset. He's gone, and it's up to Kyle Mayers, who's on strike against Akil Hussain. It's just starting to grip a bit more, Sammy, isn't it? Just a little bit of bounce, too.
I was just talking about the tactics of Kieran Pollard a little bit earlier, and the fact that Kyle Mayers is still out there, and the left unorthodox that he has with overs remaining. He's introduced them now, Akil Hussain, who carried Pierre the over before. So he has that confidence in them. He has that trust. But we've also seen Sikandar Raza bowling. And it's a wicket. Oh, he's dropped it. Speaking about Sikandar Raza, I was just about to praise you, and you let me down. You're simply not catch. You never really are. But you'd expect at this level that this would have been taken.
Says it all from TKR. Wow. And it was Kyle Mayers. Holy heck. Can Kyle Mayers make TKR pay?
And one of the points I want to make with that, that should have been a wicket. Sometimes, as captains, as the think tank, we overanalyze the situation. Let's clean them up. Bang on target there, Akil Hussain. So a drop catch in the previous delivery and success in this one.
Hashtag love this game. Can turn so quickly. Yeah, lovely, lovely bit of flight. He wanted to go across the line to the skipper. Hindsight's a wonderful thing. Would have been better to go straight back over the bowler's head, but he takes on mid-wicket instead of long off. And it costs Jason Holder. He's gone for three, and the Trident's now 95 for three. burly left-hander out of Canterbury, Christchurch, New Zealand. Corey Anderson spends a bit of time in Texas these days. A couple of other Kiwis I know live in Texas. So Anderson, crucial time because he's got a bit of time, because Jason Holder wanted to go across the line instead of maybe going straighter. So Anderson, now with calm ears, has got a great job to do to get on with it. He's certainly got a bit of time. We've still got 5.5 overs of the Trident's innings. Found a bit of form just of late, Corey Anderson.
Oh boy, lovely.
Sensible sign.
Yeah, they've really set up things nicely, the Barbados Australians, to explode in the back five because of Jason Holder. I might just have slowed down a little bit, and I won't be surprised if Captain Pollard brings in Sikander Raza because of his off spin. Goes safe, falls safely. So the intent is there quite early from Corey Anderson. Point I was making, and if I can make it really quickly, the ball that comes into the batsman has a greater strike rate, has a greater possibility of getting a wicket, and the one that leaves has a lower economy rate. So in terms of matchups, a lot of captains choose the economy over the strike rate.
There you go. Thank you, Sammy B. Spot on. Mears, one to go here from Hussain. Where does he go?
Lovely boy, lovely lad.
He's going to keep the strike. That's what's going to happen. 15 bowled. Tridents are now 97 for 3.
Last five overs, an important passage of play, more so for the Tridents. They're looking to accelerate. Maybe 10 or 15 runs behind at this stage of the innings, you would think. But all credit to the Knight Riders. Pollard using his bowlers, rotating them. Pollard himself being economical, most economical on that list of TKR bowlers.
Reload.
Understand a lot of the owners looking on. Chalak Mitra Group, the boys in Dallas, Manish Al, Ron. So too on the TKR side, Venki Maiso not being able to make the trip. So too Shahrukh Khan surely will be looking on. Good morning, Tom Moody.
Yes, good morning, Darren. Yeah, I'm sure there are just a few of many people that are watching this Hero CPL very closely. Particularly with cricket being starved like many other sports, live cricket that is. It's great that we've managed to get the Hero CPL up and running here in Trinidad, and it's starting to really shaped nicely with one more week of cricket left down at the Lara Cricket Academy, and then we've got the finals the following week. So certainly these two teams will be hoping to be playing at the back end. TKR look like they're just about secured in that position.
From what we've noticed, a definite change in approach by the Knight Riders with the bat. And Tom, just want to get your views on this. We've seen them power their way through the innings with the bat earlier in the tournament. Now, because of the pitch, just using a different approach, being more watchful, having wickets in hand to the back end. That's because they've only secured 2 wins, third on that list so far. Knight Riders at the top.
Yeah, I quite like the approach, to be honest with you. I think it's been well thought through. I think a lot of teams and individuals would have discussed their approach to how they best post a competitive total. Look, this surface is certainly better than the previous surface we had on Thursday. And I think they're in a position with wickets in hand that they can post something above 150, and I think that will be competitive. The runs on the board when you do have a pitch that is a little bit slower and is gripping a little bit is very valuable. Not easy just to go out there and play shots as we've seen today. But they are positioned with some power hitters to be able to launch that 150 plus.
Tridents with the number one T20 bowler in the world, Rashid Khan, spoke about establishing a good total batting first. When you have a guy like this in your squad, you think you're in with a chance to defend that total. With Santana, another top class T20 bowler, New Zealand international. But for now, the focus will be batting. Nurse, Young, Reefer still to come. Very good running. Taking pace off and getting two.
It is smart batting. Anderson yet to get in and get sort of familiar with the pace on the surface. And whilst he's doing that, he's still being proactive by just a little touch into the leg side. Didn't try to overhit it so he could get back for that second. One of the ways you can get in on a surface and still be proactive on the scoreboard.
Just be searching for that boundary to finish the over. 7 runs from it so far, 2 deliveries left. What will he do? As you'd expect from Pollard, taking pace off the ball, using every bit of his experience in his bowling. You saw him change his run up a couple of times. Boy, hand washing station, an important part of life today given the global pandemic. It's an excellent over from Pollard. 8 runs from it, 105 for 3. Six bowlers used by Pollard. Spoke about matchups and balls turning into right-handers, away from left-handers. Fielding from the Knight Riders, not perfect today. That was the first drop, Tian Webster. Wasn't the easiest of chances. This should have been taken. To Kandaraza, guilty person on that occasion. Here he is with the ball.
One. It's unusual to see him drop catches too. Raza is sort of recognised as a very good fielder. Played a lot of cricket for Zimbabwe. very effective all-rounder. Primarily a batsman that bowls, I think he'd categorise his all-round skills.
Bravo settles under it and gets the wicket of Kyle Mayers. He was sitting pretty on 42. This will just slow that acceleration by the Tridents.
It was always going to be the risk with the ball turning away from the left hand, as it's harder to get your timing. And the ball is turning away towards that outside edge, and that's what was found. A thick outside edge that carried all the way to wide mid off the end of Mayers. A big wicket. He goes from 42 off 37. It's 106 for four.
Set on this surface, that is what will be disappointed on the part of the Tridents. Set batsman getting out.
Yeah!
And another use of the feet, the turn away from the left hander, doing the trick for the Knight Riders. Sikander gets his second.
It's another example of how hard it is to try to take on the ball that turns away from the bat. There's the protection when the ball's turning in to hit the inside edge or hit you in the pads or body, but when it's turning away, you slightly get it wrong and it does turn, you find yourself in the position that Corey Anderson has found himself, and that is walking off the park for just six to your name. It's 107 for five.
Bit of a slide here for the Tridents. Flurry of wickets going down. Last one, bit of a loud Rashid Khan to come to the crease. Healthy strike rate 147.
Oh boy.
Corey Anderson looking to take on that deep mid-off boundary. Just the flight of delivery, the turn off the surface was his undoing. Raza 2 for 3. 2 wickets for just the 3 runs, the 4 balls he's delivered so far.
Launches this one, Ashley Nurse. That's his role, to come and add a little bit of an impetus to the innings with the bat, and he's done so. Boundary very early.
Very first ball for Ashley Nurse. Hasn't held back. He's had everything thrown at that. Just going with the spin. It's just an example how easy it is to hit with the spin. Games where the left-handers have had to try to deal with it with the ball turning away.
And again, just going over the head of that fielded short third man. Too much width on offer. Line a little bit too wide, and it will end on a high. 17 gone, 116 for 5.
throwing the kitchen sink at this one as well. That bat speed there is just enough to be able to elevate the ball over the infield.
Very good last over for the Tridents. Aaron Pollard, with the introduction of Raza, was able to get two wickets out of him. Not sure he might be an option use for the remaining three. Pollard himself with one over left out of his complement of four. And this man will complete his four overs. Strike, Rashid Khan delivering the big shot early, gets the boundary.
It was interesting, Fawad Ahmed pushed this one through, recognising that Rashid was going to attack him. But by pushing it through, it also limits his ability to turn the ball. So he's nearly better off, in my view, still trying to spin the ball hard and maybe just take a little bit of pace off it. He might find himself in a position where he gets a comfortable stumping with the ball turning past the outside edge. Which he's done. Beautifully bowled.
Just keeping it very close as well. Doesn't allow the arms to be free. Just look how he's cramped there. Delivery just close to that front leg. Gets it this time Hero Maximum turning out to be an expensive over.
This is well played, getting deep in his crease and taking full advantage of the shorter length in the delivery. Pulls it away with great force. The challenge for the spinners when they're under pressure, they tend to bowl it a little bit faster. And when you're bowling it faster, it's hard to maintain the energy on the ball, the rotation, the spin on the ball. And in a way, it becomes a little bit easier for batsmen who are in his frame of mind to be able to swing through it and find the boundary. It takes a lot of courage to be able to just continue to try to spin the ball hard and get it up there.
Length so crucial as a bowler at this stage of the innings. So as you mentioned, Tom, even as you try to change your pace on your delivery, still got to be consistent with your length. A guy like Rashid is short, so he'll use the depth of the crease, so you might have to make an adjustment.
Beautiful! Beautiful, a Republic Bank classic, as if to make up for the one that he dropped earlier. Yeah, that's more like the Sukhinder Raza we're used to seeing in the field. He's a very efficient cricketer, whether he's batting, bowling, and in this case, in the field. Good diving catch. Excellent diving catch to his left, and that's an important wicket because this pair was starting to threaten with a partnership of 21 off just 9 deliveries. It's the end of Rashid Khan. He goes for 12. It's 128-6.
Santana, New Zealand international, has played some useful and handy innings for the Tridents. he's here because of this.
Yeah, moved nicely to his non-preferred side, the left side, and there's the frustration, and I think that's all to do with the catch he dropped a couple of overs ago. Jaden Seals into the attack.
Excellent start. We've seen him be afforded the opportunity to bowl at this stage of the innings in previous matches. We've often spoken about Hero CPL and it being a platform for young players to develop and progress in their respective careers. This young man surely growing from strength to strength. It was wide. Ashley Nurse wasn't going to let that go. Flung everything at it and picked up four.
I don't think I've ever seen someone swing at a shot like this before. Absolutely throwing everything at it, isn't he? And he knows that if he has any sort of contact, he's going to get the good fortune like this, where it goes flying over short fine leg for a boundary. Just needs to bring his line a little bit straighter so it doesn't expose that boundary.
That's beautiful. That's lovely. He's just set himself. Bats on an off stump. Gives himself room by going deep in the crease. And the execution, brilliant.
Well, shots like this is helping the Tridents achieve that 150 plus. They're only 12 away now from achieving that 150. And if the likes of Nurse manage to continue to innovate like this and move across his crease and take advantage of the width that's on offer, they're going to track down that additional 12 plus runs easily.
Gets the line a little bit straighter. Dream 11, this is a young man you might have had in your Dream 11 team. You can log on to dream11.com or download the app. Quite a few players announcing themselves in Hero CPL 2020. Just look at how Ashley Nurse goes deep in the crease, and the reason why he does that is to get under the ball, negate that Yorker length. Can't show the bowler you're doing that too early because he can make the adjustment.
He's well bowled, change of pace. Ashley Nurse has just tried to put the bowler off with a little bit of fancy footwork before he's released it. I think the very first player to start doing that was Dean Jones. And that's just another shot square of the wicket of that six. Didn't try to overhit it either. But yeah, Dean Jones is one of the first to sort of just use his fancy footwork before the ball is delivered just to throw the bowler off his length.
Keeper under it. Simply taken in the end, Tim Seifert. Jaden Seals gets another. Ashley Nurse has to depart.
Wonderful to see young talent bounce back after being punished a couple of times in this over. He's done well. He'll learn a lot from these experiences, the good and the bad. It's all part of their development, and this young man has got a bright future, there's no doubt about that. Nurse goes for a handy 19, just off the nine balls, it's 138 for seven.
Pollard to bowl the last over.
Catch it as a cry. It goes over the fence. This guy is effective. Mid-Santana gets a hero maximum.
Very first ball too. Not an easy thing to do, and that's a very handy way to start this last over. Pollard just banging it in off that good length, and Santner just having a good old swing through and found that boundary. That's straight mid-wicket.
Excellent thing about that hero maximum, that delivery didn't have a lot of pace on it. Often very difficult to get pace with a swing. Ashley Nurse might have been expecting that full delivery. Seals going short, making the right decision. Shy of 150. Psychologically, the Tridents will feel good about that score set. Batting first, Pollard, as we've seen, is very confident with the Knight Riders batting. Last time these two teams match, Knight Riders got to 185.
What's your view? Do you think that 150 range is a good score to post first up?
Given what we've seen, of course, I think the mere fact that we've seen a different approach by the Tridents in terms of their batting, that again suggests that they're comfortable with a 150-160 score. We've seen them set the innings up, having not lost a lot of wickets in the power play and middle overs. Should have been called a wide.
It was well wide of off stump. Yeah, I think that's got to be called wide. That's well out of reach, particularly when you consider the angle of the delivery as well.
Last ball. Waits on it. There is a fielder, so no boundary. Was an opportunity for two. Good sportsmanship shown here by Mitch Santner. Return mid-contact.